The Bay Area and the rest of California experienced dry weather in January and rain in February, but people are still concerned that they might not have enough water to wash their cars, water the plants, and fill up their swimming pools. Here to talk with us about the current state of our water conditions is Dr. John Monteverde, who is a meteorology professor at San Francisco State. Welcome to the show, Dr. Monteverde.
Thank you very much. I'm glad to be here.
It's great having you here, too. Now, can you review for us our recent weather and the resulting water conditions for the state of California?
It's been a big change from January, as you pointed out. We've had a lot of rain in the last 2 weeks. Most of the major cities north of Santa Barbara have had quite a lot of rain in the Bay Area, between 8 and 12 inches of rain in the last 2 weeks. So that's really lessened the drought.
Wow, that's actually pretty good. That's actually pretty good. But has this eliminated the concern about a drought this year?
No, because that's just rainfall in the last 2 weeks. We'll have to wait March and April, and then finally we're going to need to worry about the runoff from the mountains, the snow melt, because that's the ultimate source of water for the major urban areas and also agriculture.
So we're going to have to wait and see if we get more rain in the next couple months, plus see what happens with the snowbank filling up.
That's exactly right, because the water that falls as rainfall in the Bay Area is less important than the amount of snowfall that occurs in the heavier precipitation areas. The snowmelt from that is what actually fills up the reservoirs.
How has the spell of dry weather affected farmers in the Central Valley who need water for their crops like corn and other goods?
Not much, because they don't depend on precipitation for their irrigation. They depend on this snowmelt. So right now they're waiting, they're holding their breaths to see how much snowfall occurs in the mountains and then how much of that works its way down into the reservoirs in the spring.
Okay, so basically we're going to have to wait and see what happens with all the incoming rain in the next couple weeks.
That's right.
Now, how much more rain and increase in the snowpack do we need to not be worried about a drought?
For this year, we're about, for this time of year, 90% of normal. So if we just had a normal March and April, we'll probably get close to normal for the year. But that does not address the longer-term issues. We've had fluctuating precipitation amounts over the last 5 years or so. And so water conservation, no matter what happens this year, is going to be a very important thing.
What should people in California in the Bay Area do to lessen their water concerns?
They need to conserve at the local level. That means when they take showers, save some of that water that you use to run to get the water from cold to hot and use that to water your plants. Don't flush the toilet unless you need to. Don't take long showers. Make sure you don't water the yard every day.
Basically, the real answer to this is conserve water.
Absolutely. We should conserve water all the time. This is not dire. We are not in dire straits, but we still need to conserve water.
That's very important indeed to keep us from running out of it. In your opinion, how is the dry California weather related to a long-term trend of global warming?
It's part of the projections for global warming for California is actually for increased precipitation, at least for the first half of the 21st century. But that increased precipitation will be within a background of huge extremes, very heavy years, very dry years. So right now we could be in one of those very dry years, and so it is consistent with our projections for global warming.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, I'm just encouraging people to maintain watchfulness on conservation, not to overreact to these short-term dry periods like the one we had in January in which, you know, catastrophes were predicted. Then look what happened here in February.
Conserve, conserve, conserve. Yes, indeed. Well, thank you, Dr. Monteverde, for talking with us today.
Have a good day. I enjoyed it.
To learn more about Dr. Monteverde, log on to tornado.sfsu.edu and click on his name. Coming up next, we're going to talk to a Caltrans representative about the new HOV lane in the North Bay and how it's benefiting commuters. Stay tuned. We'll be right back. Welcome to SFSU Talk. I'm Brian McCallen. Caltrans opened a new high-occupancy vehicle, or HOV lane, in the North Bay last month. The new lane is designed for carpooling on Highway 101, which is a constant traffic nightmare for commuters. Will there be truly a nightmare no more with this new road? We have Bob Haas here from Caltrans to give us that answer and tell us more about the HOV lane and how it will benefit commuters. Welcome to the show, Bob.
Well, thank you very much, Brian.
Now, why was the North Bay southbound HOV lane built in the first place?
Well, two reasons. Number one, this is an area, a section where the roadway narrows down from four lanes to three. So that was a chronic bottleneck there. So by expanding it from three lanes to four, we eliminated that bottleneck. So it's now a straight shot. But the other important thing is, for having the HOV lane there, the high occupancy vehicle lane, there is no BART and there is no Caltrain running through Marin County or Sonoma County. So until now, there hasn't been a viable option to solo commuting. You know, you drive alone in your car or else. Now there is bus service, but without the HOV lane, that doesn't do you much good. So now, if you're on a bus or in an express, in an employee van pool or in a carpool, you have a straight shot from Highway 37 in the north down to the Golden Gate Bridge.
Now, is this going to basically, this basically helps reduce traffic, correct?
Yeah, it reduces congestion, which also reduces air pollution because you don't have as many idling vehicles.
Right.
And then it also encourages people to commute in some other way other than solo commuting.
Yeah, but what exactly is the route of this new lane? I know you said it goes through the Golden Gate Bridge, but what from what city to what city or what part of the Bay Area does this?
Well, it starts at the intersection of Highway 101 and Highway 37 in the north up by Novato, and goes all the way south to just before the Waldo Tunnel. So that's the length of the carpool lane there.
Can you tell our listeners where the Waldo Tunnel is?
That's just south of Mill Valley and just north of Sausalito. So just after you come up the Golden Gate Bridge, as you're headed north into Marin County, you'll go through the Waldo Tunnel. And it's just north of that where the carpool lane starts.
That's pretty good. So it's going to really help commuters trying to get to San Francisco to work or play.
Mm-hmm.
The commute much easier. Basically, this new lane is going to really help ease the congestion for commuters, right?
That's right, and it already has, because we opened up the southbound lane on February 1st. And so that means there's no longer that bottleneck where the freeway narrows down from four lanes to three. It's four lanes consistently almost all the way through Marin County now. Three regular lanes and the HOV lane. Now the only problem we have right now is at the top of the hill, there's still some construction going on. So we have some of the concrete barriers. And that kind of narrows things, gives people a little bit of a claustrophobic feeling. Plus the freeway is pretty rough from all the construction going on. So we still have people slowing down there a bit. But once that's all done, then you know that'll be just smooth sailing from north to south. And then the other big thing is finishing up the northbound lane, which we hope to have open sometime in late April.
Can you please tell me more about that northbound lane?
Well, the northbound lane, yeah, the same start and end points, you know, from the intersection, it's actually the intersection of Highway 1 in the south to the intersection of Highway 37 in the north. So that's pretty much all of Marin County, or at least the most densely populated areas of it. So before, people had to slog their way through, you know, with people getting on and off and going through the very heavily populated segments of Marin County. Now, if you're in an express bus or a van pool or a carpool, you'll just sail right on through.
Quickly now, what specific improvements can commuters look forward to once both lanes are finished? I know you discussed about less traffic, but what other improvements are positive effects?
Yeah, having the new HOV lane, which is giving people an alternative to solo commuting, and then getting rid of the bottlenecks, both north and south, because there's a bottleneck going north also. So it's consistent, three regular lanes and the HOV lane all the way through Marin County. And then other good features of it is there's a bicycle and pedestrian path.
Well, Bob, we thank you so much for talking with us today, but we got to go. Thanks for being on the show.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
To learn more about the new HOV lane, go to dot.ca.gov/dist4/Marin101HOV. We're going to go to a commercial, but when we come back, we'll talk to Tri-Valley Repertory Theater's Carol Hovey about their production of A Chorus Line in Livermore. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.